after my video on my glucose test, explaining how I did the process, how I did my test at home, I received a lot of feedback from some of my subscribers asking me, how do you measure 75 grams of glucose? Because the pack that is usually 125 grams and then there's a few extra grams. So we don't readily receive a glucon-D or a glucose pack which says it's only 75 grams which we can use for our glucose test. So to make life easier for all you pregnant mamas out there, I actually measured 75 grams. So I've weighed these 75 grams on a weighing scale. So as you can see, it's close enough. It's about 76 grams on the scale. I couldn't get 75 exact. Okay, but fair enough. We have roughly approximate this to be 75 grams. And then let's measure how many tablespoons this is. So let's have a look. Now we know that it is 8 tablespoons of glucose that makes half a glass. Okay, so that's 75 grams. If you're measuring as teaspoons, it's approximately 14 teaspoons. So you can have a look at that as well. If you are still confused whether you should use a teaspoon or a tablespoon, and if you're someone who bakes and you have access to a one cup measure, then you can see it's approximately half of a 1 cup measure.
It is a 1 cup measure. So
now that you have seen the different ways to measure 75 grams of glucose, I have the glass of glucose here. Now it might look like it's a whole half a glass. I will pour the water into this. The entire thing dissolves. Just give me a second. So you can see how it is. Okay, so I've put it in. I might need to add a little more water. So it bubbles up a little bit, but it's actually not gaseous at all. So we'll stir it. See, there's still, it's very cold because as the glucose dissolves, I can feel the glass getting colder and colder. So it will become, the entire thing will dissolve. You can add the entire glass of water. Okay, so this would be how it is after you add the water to the 75 grams of glucose. You can stir it nicely, okay, and drink this on an empty stomach in the morning. So you would have to give your blood sample before drinking the 75 grams of glucose and your blood sample after you drink the 75 grams of glucose. Now, another thing to note is this is really sweet. So some clinics or some hospitals, instead of giving you glucose directly, they might give you an orange flavored drink or any other Tetra Pak drink would be made available to you in your hospital, depending on where you are located. So what happened to me after taking the glucose test, it was really sweet. I was experiencing a lot of morning sickness. Luckily, I did not puke the glucose. At the time, I was able to hold it down for 2 hours to get my glucose test done. And but in order for me to stay calm and to not feel the nausea, I did go to sleep. So I slept for the 2.5 hours and then I went back to the clinic. So since I did the test at home, I had the opportunity to go to sleep. But if you have to do the test and wait for 2.5 hours in the clinic itself, then I would suggest just rest. Don't try and do anything tedious. And I hope that your glucose test goes well for you. Do drop down any comments or any questions that you may have. So remember, 8 tablespoons or 14 and a half teaspoons or half a cup. And approximately this is what it would look like. So wishing you all the best for your glucose test. Bye.